Back in Foxborough, 40 degrees, not nearly as windy as it was when we were here at practice on Friday, but rain is expected.
Yeah, the weather has been changing all weekend long, and it will continue to change this afternoon. It was beautiful earlier this morning, sunny skies, not much wind, but it is starting to change.
Patriots have lost their last two. Panthers without Jake DeLone for the second consecutive week. New England won the toss but deferred. Kostowski's kickoff taken by Tyrell Sutton, and Sutton spins across the 30 out to the 32-yard line. Kyle Arrington made the tackle. So Matt Moore, in his third season out of Oregon State, making his second start this season, fifth of his career for the injured Jake DeLone.
And I understand the reasoning behind John Fox and what he's been doing offensively the latter part of the season. Let's minimize those turnovers. A lot of them come out of the passing game, but Matt Moore, in his second start, can you give him a little bit of trust? Does he have the confidence to throw the ball around? That's where the Patriots have really struggled over the last month.
D'Angelo Williams returns to the backfield, did not play last week in the win over Tampa. And this is Williams bottled up at the line.
Well, if they're going to throw the ball early, they better throw the ball early there, Moose, because the weather coming in, you could struggle a little bit more here going into the second half.
Yeah, and it's going to be tough to run the football into this Patriot front. They're very good at shutting down the run. Obviously, Adalys Thomas is out. Pierre Woods gets the start for him. But here's the area that New England has struggled with: communication in the back end. And if Carolina really wants to have an opportunity to be able to keep pace with this explosive Patriot offense, they're going to have to get out of their comfort zone and throw it a little.
Off the play fake on second and 10. Moore could not find anyone and then throws it away.
Well, I'll tell you, if he gets that much time in the backfield, he's going to be successful. That offensive line did a great job of keeping him free.
Well, it's a three-man rush, Tony. You're going to bring three guys. And he's got to have the confidence that pocket's there. Watch 87, Musa Muhammad on the in route right behind Steve Smith. He breaks open late right in the center of the field. But Matt Moore had moved off his spot. He did not need to move off that spot. As you pointed out, Tony, that was good protection.
Three wide receivers, Steve Smith in the slot, third down and 10. Moore on third down. Muhammad got a hand on it but could not pull it in.
And that is absolutely one thing that Carolina cannot afford to do. And it's one of those things that they'll struggle with if they decide to throw the football, is three and outs. They had two incomplete passes on that series. Matt Moore just settled down, you know, relax. This is a difficult environment to play in.
Jason Baker back at his own 18. Wes Welker, second in the NFL in punt return average, back deep for New England. Welker from the 22. And across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 13-yard return as Tom Brady leads the second-ranked Patriots offense out for the first time today.
Yeah, and you know, you hear a lot about Tom Brady and what he does as a quarterback, throwing the football, you know, coordinating this New England offense. But I tell you what, he is a tough guy too. He is banged up. He's got some rib issues. He's got a shoulder, got a bad finger on the throwing hand. I mean, he is really banged up at this stage of the season, but he is out there playing. This is not the same team without Tom Brady.
He's a fighter.
Empty backfield on first and 10 from the 36-yard line. Brady backpedaling, and then he throws it away. Penalty marker back at the 25-yard line.
Personal foul, grasping the face mask. Defense number 92. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Damian Lewis.
When you're a team that's really, really struggling during the course of the season, these types of plays just seem to happen week after week. You get some pressure on Tom Brady, you move him off of his spot, and he's got to throw it away. And all of a sudden, you've got a 15-yard face mask penalty that gives them the first down and puts them in top, inside your end of the field.
Lawrence Maroney in the backfield, two tight ends.
Alert! 20!
From the Carolina 49, this is Maroney. And he fights his way back towards the line of scrimmage. Hollis Thomas brought him down.
Tell you what, Chris Harris did a great job of support on that edge coming up to go and turn him back inside. That's a nice job from that secondary going and realizing it's a run and going and go help them guys out up there on that defensive line.
And there's Charles Johnson getting the start for Tyler Brayton. That's why we've got the 13th consecutive different starting defensive group this season for the Carolina Panthers.
Second down at 11. Off the fake to Maroney. Brady's pass is caught by Maroney. And Maroney able to gain 5 yards to the 45-yard line.
Tell you what, that defensive line has got to do a better job. Watch them. They're all just standing up, playing the run right there. That is not pass rushing. These guys got to go and identify whether it's going to be a run or a pass earlier to get pressure on Tom Brady.
It seemed like Charles Johnson, number 95, the left end, was the only player that was moving forward with the rush.
When we talk about communication, he's got to go and relay that it's a pass all the way down that defensive line and let everybody know what it's going to be.
Six defensive backs for Carolina. Falk in the backfield for New England. Third down and six. Brady, pump fakes. He throws. And the catch is made by Welker. It will depend on the spot. Looks to be a bit short.
I tell you, he is virtually uncoverable. And Tom Brady thinks he is uncoverable. And it doesn't matter whether you've got two guys on him or three guys on him. He has such a great feel. And Chris Harris told us, he said, it's not so much that he's running a specific route. He's kind of playing you off the leverage that you're defending him with. So if you're heavy outside, he's going to work inside. If you've got an inside leverage on him, he's going to work to his outside. He's got a tremendous feel of finding those soft spots and coverages.
The only thing he can really do is try to go and pressure him on the line of scrimmage and try to disrupt the timing between Tom Brady and Wes Welker. But you got to go and bump and run him. You got to bump him up on the line of scrimmage. And that's what I think we're going to see out of this Carolina team.
Now, the other thing, Tony, he makes his hay coming across the middle. And, you know, you've got to be physical with him. You've got to let him know that in that five-yard area, he's not going to have a free pass to come across the formation.
Patriots will go for it on fourth down. Side handoff.
They didn't get back to the 40.
Terrific job. Hollis Thomas coming through to make the first contact on Sammy Morris.
You wonder if Coach Belichick is ever going to start to second guess some of these decisions. He says it's from week to week and in the best interest of the team, but those are three big fourth down plays they've missed. We talked at the top about those handful of plays during the course of a game that are critical in determining who's going to win or lose. And there's an example of one right there. You elect to go for it on fourth down. It's early in the game. I would have liked to have seen New England punt the ball, keep playing field position right now. You give Carolina great field position, and they've really, really struggled during the course of this season to move the ball effectively.
On first down, Moore looking for Muhammad. Nearly picked off. And then Steve Smith attempted to make the catch. James Sanders thought he had it.
Well, right now, the Carolina Panthers have people open, but they're just not getting them the ball. Matt Moore has been high on several of his throws. Again, here he's got Moose and Muhammad right in the middle of the field, wide open. And again, there's another one of those plays. James Sanders has got to make that interception.
Patriots got to be smart with staying off of Moore, too, after he delivers that ball. We'll get a penalty.
Second down and 10, Williams. D'Angelo Williams out to the 45-yard line, a gain of four.
And I don't mean to sound critical of the approach that Carolina has taken, you know, during the course of the season, because it has produced very good results for them. You know, they have a very, very good record when they're playing this conservative run-first style of offense. I'm a person who looks at the game and says, where do we have our best opportunity to have success this afternoon? You've got to maintain a little bit of that balance, but I really feel if they can get Matt Moore to settle down a little bit and start making good throws, there are plays to be made in the passing game against this Patriots secondary.
That's three passing plays. Musa Muhammad's wide open in the middle of the field.
On third and six, pass intended for the tight end, Dante Rosario, and Matt Moore have started the game 0 for 4.
Well, Dante Rosario's got to make this catch. You know, and sometimes you're going to be high, sometimes the ball's going to be in a tough position, but that's a catchable one.
Panthers go three and out for the second consecutive possession. Baker from the 34. Fair catch called for by Welker at the 21-yard line. 34-yard punt. No score. 4 minutes gone by in Foxborough. Second possession for the Patriots offense. From their own 21-yard line. Maroney, big hole. Out across the 30, gain of 9.
That's the other thing about this Patriot offense. As Tony talked about at the top, it is all based on throwing the football to Wes Welker, to Randy Moss, you know, utilizing Tom Brady. But they can run the ball if they want, and it was interesting to talk to them on Friday and hear not only Wes but also Tom say, we need to run the ball better. You know, when we get into situations and the opportunities are there, we've got to be able to run the ball effectively, because that is going to make that passing game even more dangerous.
22. Kevin Falk picks up a first down across the 35. John Beeson finally made the tackle. Patriots with three wideouts on the field, keep it on the ground and move the chains.
Well, they kind of get you thinking. You know, you talked about the three wideouts, and then you've got Kevin Falk in the backfield, and all of a sudden you're thinking pass. Pre-snap, you've got to be thinking pass. A little quick inside draw to Kevin Falk to get some good yards to move the chains.
Two tight ends, Maroney back in.
52. 20.
On first and 10 from the 36, Maroney running left, has a first down and more. Lawrence Maroney into Carolina Panthers territory, gain of 17 as we check in with Kurt Menefee. Kurt,
can you move some goose?
All right, thanks very much, Kurt. Fast start for the Houston Texans, first and 10 from the Carolina 47. Again, it is Maroney. Dan Connor makes the tackle, gain of 3.
Well, let's go back to that previous play before we headed out to L.A. to talk to Kurt. Watch Julius Peppers. He has the potential to dominate a game. You cannot be blocked like this by a tight end. He is too good. He is too good of a defensive lineman to allow a tight end to block him. I don't care if it's on a long trap, but there's a little bit of deception to it. Julius Peppers is too good of a player to allow that block to happen.
He's got to keep that outside leverage. He's got to turn everything back inside where his help is.
Second down and 7. Sammy Morris, who was stopped on that fourth down on the Patriots' first possession. Morris down to the 40, gain of 4.
You know, the Patriots running the ball, having success. Next thing you're going to know is you're going to get that secondary gone, moving up a little bit, and play actions coming up, Darryl.
Yeah, Chris Harris has already dropped down into the box a couple of times, Tony. So it looks like he's going to be your eighth guy up there. He drops in. And you know, Tom is going to take advantage of that. It's just a matter of time before somebody slips behind that defense and you've got a long pass play.
Third down and 3. Brady to the outside. And Welker could not hang on.
And that is a tremendous job by the Carolina secondary, because it's one of the difficult things. Wes Welker will come in motion and he'll release behind Randy Moss right there. That's that leverage thing. Is Wes Welker going to break to the inside or is he going to break to the outside? Watch how they play this. This is well done. That's an excellent job. Now they turned Randy Moss loose a little bit, but they had Wes Welker covered.
Everybody's worried about Wes Welker.
Chris Hansen punting for midfield. Fair catch at the 20-yard line by Captain Mutterlin. Still scoreless in Foxborough. You never know who might show up holding one of our parabolic mics.
Well, you know what? He's getting ready to get real busy here pretty soon. I'm surprised that he's down here with us this afternoon. I would think that he's got quite a bit of work to do in preparation.
He's got a lot of help. Everybody's a football fan now.
D'Angelo Williams picks up a first down. Out to the 33-yard line. The first down for Carolina today.
They have explosive capabilities in the run game. And when you talk conservative and you talk run first, when you have D'Angelo Williams and also Jonathan Stewart in the backfield, I mean, you can get a big play out of that running game. And especially with that 1-2 punch being back in the lineup today. D'Angelo was out last week.
The sixth leading rusher of the National Football League, already over 1,000 yards.
Can't do that.
Initial pressure from Jarvis Green and then Ty Warren. Loss of two.
That's good team defense right there. A lot of times when you've got the ability to change direction and move quickly like D'Angelo Williams does, you think you can get to the outside. But if you're playing good team defense, if you're doing your job, almost every time you try and make that play happen, it's going to blow up on you.
Yeah, the longer the run takes, the more guys you're going to have running to the ball. So if you're going to hit that hole, you got to hit it hard and fast.
Second down at 12. It's Williams again. And again, it's Ty Warren who makes the tackle.
It looks like Carolina wanted to come out at the start of this game and be a little bit more aggressive and challenge that New England secondary, but they didn't have success. They did not execute. There were plays to be made, and they did not make them. And now you've got to kind of establish some type of offensive rhythm because you went three and out on your first two series. So John Fox kind of getting back into that mentality. All right, let's start running it again. But you'll get some of these situations. You got a third and long against the Patriots.
Three wide receiver set. Panthers must get across the 43. This is Tyrell Sutton out of the backfield. And Sutton tackled at the 39-yard line by Gerard Mayo. Gain of 8. Panthers will punt for the third time. Busy first quarter for Jason Baker. Walker moving to his left, takes it up to 14. And brought down at the 21-yard line by Dan Connor. So the Patriots offense, Wes Welker, Randy Moss, when we return. Back in Foxborough, Kenny Albert, Darryl Johnston, Tony Siragusa. Patriots have won 24 of their last 27 December games since the 2003 season. Scoreless today with the Carolina Panthers. Quick out to Welker, his second catch, and he's tackled at the 29 by Everett Brown, a gain of 7.
Well, we've seen both of these offenses lean back on the run game, Tony, but you think they need to change their thought?
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Right now, this is Boston area right here, but look what's coming. This is all coming our way, and it's thick behind there. So if you're going to pass the ball, you better pass it now because it's going to be a little tougher in that second half with that rain coming in.
Our staff meteorologist, Tony Siragusa. Second down and 3. Maroney cuts it back inside and picks up the first down. Out to the 36-yard line, gain of 7.
Good patience by Lawrence Maroney. Pressing that ball to the outside, press it, let your guys get on a track and then get back inside as Richard Marshall limps off the field for the Carolina Panthers.
From the 36, off the fake to Maroney. Brady took a hit as he got rid of the football, and it's off the hands of Randy Moss.
Randy Moss did a nice job of running this route. He just sat down in a void right in the middle of the field right there, Darryl.
Randy Moss getting into that soft spot that Tony talked about, a little release off the line of scrimmage. And then right here, watch how he just kind of gears it down. And Tom Brady's going to try and get it in there and let him use his ability to elevate to make that catch.
Brady on second and 10. Brady fires, intended for Moss, and it is Chris Gamble who comes away with the interception, his fourth of the season.
Well, there was one last week against the Miami Dolphins in the end zone where I thought Randy Moss could have made a better play on the ball. Let's see if this is similar. It's a little bit too far outside, but he came out of his break awful slow.
Tom Brady's last pass intended for Randy Moss, intercepted by Chris Gamble. Panthers had five picks against Tampa Bay last week, and for Gamble, third consecutive game with an interception. Well, the Panthers start in Patriots territory from the 48-yard line. First carry today for Jonathan Stewart, who gained seven.
Let's go back and take a look at this interception. I think Randy Moss was confused by the coverage. He's not really pushing it off the release either. I mean, we talk about coming out of the break, but there never seemed to be a sense of urgency with this route. Now, whether he felt that Tom Brady was going to go somewhere else in his progression, I just didn't see Randy Moss really give a whole lot of effort from the start of that play to the interception.
Tell you what, the ball was put in a place where Randy Moss could have made that play.
Looking down and three off the fake to Stewart. Moore going deep for Steve Smith. Smith goes up and makes the catch for a touchdown.
Little things. It's little things and it's attention to detail. And I know all the Patriot fans out there would love to have like something concrete, something definite that the coaching staff and the players could work on during the course of the week to get this ship righted. But sometimes it's not about that. It's about the little things. It's about the attention to detail. And right there, a route that's poorly run, a miscommunication with your quarterback leads to a turnover, and then you've got an opportunity to make a play on the ball. You don't make it, and you let Steve Smith catch the touchdown pass.
John Casey adds the extra point for Steve Smith, his fifth touchdown this season, and the first touchdown pass for Matt Moore since the last game back in 2007.
Well, they're going to get the coverage that they want. They're going to get one-on-one. Steve Smith versus Sean Springs. They get Brandon Merriweather to bite up and open up the center of the field. Matt Moore on that one puts it in the right spot. Put it out into the middle of the field and let the wide receiver run to the ball.
Sean Springs back in the Patriots lineup today. Inactive, Darryl, the last four games.
Yeah, I think a lot of people wondering why Sean Springs was not on the field. If your pass defense is struggling and you've got a little bit of youth in your secondary, why not go to one of the veteran guys that you picked up in the offseason? And Sean Springs gets out there today and gives up a big touchdown pass to Steve Smith.
The Carolina Panthers capitalize on the interception by Gamble. 41-yard touchdown pass from Moore to Steve Smith. Reese Lloyd kicks off for Carolina, taken up a five by Maroney. And Maroney tackled at the 26-yard line by Jordan Sen. So the Patriots go back to work, trailing by seven. Moss, of course, one of four players who showed up late for work on Wednesday, sent home by Bill Belichick. Interesting, Moss was one of the captains who went out for the coin toss prior to the game today.
Well, I think it's a reaction to try and grab the attention of the players. This is a very crucial part of the season. I mean, the New England Patriots are not used to having the last month of the season go the way it has gone in the past. It's been a tough 4 weeks for them.
On the 26-yard line, on first down, the pass is caught by Falk. And he's run down by John Beeson after a gain of seven.
Not a lot of electricity down here on the field, Darrell.
No, not
they're very flat.
Not in the stands either, Tony.
Yeah, I mean, it's quiet down here. It's flat. It's starting to get that overcast. The wind's starting to pick up a little bit, not much, but they need something to go and spark this team back up. Because right now, I don't feel any kind of energy coming from this Patriots offense.
Second down and three. Sammy Morris up the middle, picks up a first down, and Moore out to midfield. Morris gains 18 yards.
Well, this seems to be their best offensive play so far this afternoon. Chris Baker, number 86, has really been the key to this. He's made some really nice adjustments. Watch 86 come into your screen in motion as the tight end, kind of leading that on the long trap, gets up, gets John Beeson kicked back a little bit. We've seen him make an adjustment and block Julius Peppers. We've seen him turn it up inside, get a couple of linebackers. A nice job by Chris Baker on that running play that the New England seems to be having a lot of success with early in this game.
First and 10 from midfield. Brady to Welker. Ball comes loose. And it's recovered by Falk.
Great hustle. Great awareness by Kevin Falk. And you do that because you're not being lazy. You know, the ball doesn't go to you, but you turn around and get your eyes downfield. You run a little curl route, but you're going to help out your teammate, and then all of a sudden the ball comes loose, and it makes it that much easier for you to get on the ball.
I don't know if that was a reception right there. Like he never had control of that ball.
It was, yeah, it looked like it was coming out before he had the contact.
It was ruled a catch on the field. I had the same thought, Goose.
Carolina has challenged that the pass was incomplete. Timeout.
So John Fox and Goose thinking along the same lines. A couple of pit guys. Referee Terry McCauley. It will either be second and four if the call of the field stands, or second and 10 if it was ruled no
catch. After review, the receiver did not control the pass and get 2 feet down. The pass is incomplete. Carolina is not charged with a timeout. Please set the game clock to 1 minute, 12 seconds. It'll be second and 10 on the 49.
And because John Fox won his first challenge, if he wins his next challenge, he will get a third.
Yeah, and you know, you wonder, some people may be wondering, well, why do you challenge it? It wasn't that big of a play. It wasn't going to change possession. But I think the way that Carolina is structured right now at this point in the season, that 6 yards is pretty important for them when you're talking about field position at midfield.
Absolutely. I think every yard. You know, second and 10, now all of a sudden your defense coordinator has a few more options, too, of bringing a little bit more pressure maybe into Brady's face. You know, have a little choice.
To take away the reception, Welker with two today, 97 on the season. On second and 10, this is Morris, and he runs into the arms of Peppers, and that is brought down at the 46-yard line. Brady on third and 6. Moves to his right, now his left, then throws, and the catch is made by Welker for a Patriots first down.
I tell you, they started off really, really well, but with Wes Welker, you have to stay with him all the time. Again, it's that stacked release. Watch Wes Welker get in behind Randy Moss. Watch how Carolina plays it right there. Now, Captain Munnerly goes out, but you got to stay with Wes Welker. You cannot go to sleep on this guy. He never stops. He is always working to get open.
So the Panthers lead by the score of 7-0. One quarter in the books. We'll be back in a moment. Carolina Panthers lead the New England Patriots 7-0 as we begin the second quarter. Brady complete to Moss, and he loses the football. Panthers say they have it, and they do. The second Patriots turnover.
I'm really surprised by the way that this offense is playing right now.
Sloppy, sloppy, yeah. Sloppy, man.
I tell you, that ball gets slippery on cold, dry days. You've got to get it wrapped tight. It'll slide out of the back of your arm so quickly.
Knock free by Chris Harris and recovered by Dan Connor. So Moss a part of both New England turnovers. Not more. The Panthers go back to work from their own 21. And that pass deflects off the hands of Musin Muhammad.
There's two receivers, Randy Moss and Musin Muhammad. Both have unbelievable hands. And we saw the ball come out with a turnover with Randy. And then Musin just looks like it just bounced right off his hands now.
Getting beat up out there by this ball.
Weather hasn't even come yet.
From the 21 on second down, Jonathan Stewart. And he's hit for a loss. Penalty marker out at the 27-yard line, and some extracurricular activity as well.
Holding offense, number 89.
Steve Smith.
Now we've had Carolina earlier this year, and I said it then, I'll say it again. Pound for pound.
Second down.
One of the most competitive guys out there on the field. And he is as frustrated as anybody can be with the way this season has gone for the Carolina Panthers. He's used to putting up big numbers, catches, yards, touchdowns, and it has been a frustrating year for Steve Smith. So he doesn't complain. He goes out there every week, does his job, plays physical. You see the drop off right there from the last 3 years.
He has the only touchdown of today's game, second down and 20. Stewart, Jonathan Stewart out to the 19-yard line. Gain of 8. Rod Mayo made the tackle. Darrell, you mentioned earlier, Panthers lead the league in turnovers with 31. Jake DeLome, who's out today for the second straight game, has thrown 18 interceptions, but today it's been New England Patriots who have turned the ball over twice.
Well, this Carolina defense finally starting to generate some turnovers from the opposition over the last 5 or 6 weeks. So they're trying to right that ship, get that turnover margin down a bit. It's one of the big indicators in the NFL.
Third down and 12. And Moore calls timeout with the play clock running down.
Offense, 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Yeah, I'll call the
foul
timeout in time.
Prior to the timeout being requested.
Hey, one of the things that you forget about when you're a backup quarterback in the NFL and you're running your plays at practice, you're getting the mental reps, but when you get inserted into that starting lineup, there's all these other things that come into play. The communication, the play coming in from the sideline, watching that play clock, all the things that you can't prepare for Monday, Wednesday through Friday.
On third and 17. Panthers keep it on the ground with Sutton. And now Jason Baker will come out to punt for the fourth time. Wes Welker back deep.
I'll tell you, the problem with having Wes Welker back there when you're in a slow offensive day is every time you punt, you're giving him another opportunity for a big play.
Taken at the 42 by Welker into Carolina territory. Takes it all the way back to the Panthers 41 before he was tackled by Dante Wesley. Terrific field position for the Pats. Patriots have turned the ball over on their last two possessions. Also stopped on a fourth down early in the first quarter, but terrific starting field position here from the Carolina 41.
And it's starting to rain down here on the field, guys. It's just starting right now.
He told us it was coming, Goose. Maroney. It's John Beeson who makes the tackle back at the 44-yard line. When we spoke with Bill Belichick on Friday, he referred to Beeson as a tackling machine.
Well, he is. Watch 52. There he goes. He slides over. Watch the angle he takes. Textbook. Textbook. The only thing, Tony Wright, get the head across.
That's it. Get Lawrence
Maroney. He's a big running back. He'll run through that.
You got to stop momentum. He'll run through an arm tackle now.
Beeson has led the Panthers in tackles in each of his first two seasons. Atop the charts again this year. Welker in motion, second down and 12. Brady looking for the tight end, Baker. James Anderson on the coverage.
I tell you, Tony, you mentioned the fact that there's just no emotion down on the field, whether it's the players or in the stands here for the Patriots. And there's another example. Chris Baker, it's like he's not even ready for that ball to be thrown to him.
It's amazing. I mean, it's flat. This is the flattest game I've ever done. I mean, there's nothing down here. The stands are quiet, like you said, Darryl. The players seem like, you know, when they make a mistake, they really don't care. I don't know what's going on. This is not the Patriot team that we're used to seeing.
And the Patriots have had big first halves this year. They've scored twice as many points in the first half than they have in the second half this season, but a slow start today. Third down and 12. Brady over the top to Falk. And Falk is tackled back at the 41-yard line.
Well, Kevin Falk, you know, some people consider him to be the number two receiver. A lot of people look at Wes Welker, you got to stop him, and then right away it's Kevin Falk because, you know, Randy Moss is kind of specialized in what he brings to the passing game. So Carolina's doing a nice job of being able to adjust to all these threats that the Patriot offense can throw at him.
Panthers force a rare three and out. Hansen's punt bounces inside the 10, out of bounds. Around the 7-yard line. Our crew had a terrific time Friday visiting the hall at Patriot Place. Right next to Gillette Stadium, there's the snowplow used by Mark Henderson 27 years ago yesterday as John Smith connected from 33 yards out. Patriots over the Dolphins 3-0. Carolina Panthers lead the Patriots today 7-0 as D'Angelo Williams gains 3 out to the 10-yard line.
The thing that I enjoyed about that trip over was the fact that it's a celebration of football here in the New England area at Patriot Hall. It's not just about the New England Patriots. Obviously, they're the fixture, the feature of that building. But, you know, the Pop Warner level, the high school level, the college level, the history of football. And Robert Kraft said it's really a celebration and a tribute to the fans here in the New England area that love the game of football.
86,000 square feet. Second down and 7. Moore gets rid of it, and the catch is made by the tight end, Gary Barnage, his 11th reception this season. And Barnage gains 8 yards.
A nice job by Matt Moore getting the ball out. He was under a lot of pressure. Found the tight end there on the outside. They came right through that offensive line, let those guys right through and get that ball off and make a completion. That's a great job by Matt.
That is a very, very difficult play for a right-handed quarterback.
Moore split out to the right on third down and 1. The direct snap to Steve Smith. And a terrific second effort after he broke away from Lee Bonin, who attempted to make the tackle. So Smith, out of the Wildcat, picks up the Carolina first down.
Everybody's trying it there.
I tell you, I might have to get a different guy besides Steve Smith because I don't think he's ever going to give the ball. He's never given the ball to D'Angelo Williams on the read keep. I mean, Tully Bandicane played him, and then he had Lee Bonin
with the Patriots. As Moore fires downfield, Smith, the intended receiver, and he took a hard hit from James Sanders.
And a nice clean hit by James Sanders. Steve Smith coming on the outside on that deep in route underneath Musa Muhammad. He knows he's going to get hit, but James Sanders does it the right way. It's not helmet to helmet. It's not towards the head. Puts it shoulder to shoulder.
But how fast does Steve Smith get up off the ground? He is not giving anybody any satisfaction or giving a good shot. Watch it. Boom. Jumps right back up. Let's go again, boys.
Second down and 10. Stewart. It's Will Ford.
You know, for years now, Tony, it's really been this Patriot offense that when you've gotten into a game where you have a lull like this, that they make a play that all of a sudden jump starts everything. And right now, it really seems like that's going to be the responsibility of the defense. Tom Brady and his group have had a number of opportunities with good field position, but haven't been able to hit that big play.
Third down and 8. Panthers must get to the 28-yard line. A penalty marker. Pass is high, intended for Smith.
Illegal shift. Offense. Two men moving part of the snap. Did not reset for a second. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
So Jason Baker will punt for the fifth time in this first half, with the Panthers leading the Patriots 7-0. Baker from his own 10, punting to Welker. Patriots will start from their own 43-yard line, trailing by 7. Rain continues to fall here in Foxborough, with the Panthers leading the Patriots 7-0. First and 10 for Tom Brady and the Pats from their own 43-yard line. Empty backfield. Brady in trouble, gets away from Peppers, and then throws it away. So for the New England Patriots, so far in this first half, some miscues. They go for it on 4th and 1 and are stopped, and a couple of turnovers as well.
Well, no sense of urgency right now. They've had great field position this entire first half. Carolina has really done nothing to be able to change that, so they continue to get opportunities near midfield and a lot of times in the Carolina end. And we talked at it at the top. There's those handful of plays during the course of the game, and New England has had an opportunity to make a few of them. At this point in the game, they haven't. And Carolina, you know, they're one real opportunity to get some points. Matt Moore is able to get it to Steve Smith for a long touchdown pass.
Lawrence Maroney gained 6 out to the 49-yard line, setting up 3rd down and 4. Brady threw 1 pick, intended for Randy Moss. Moss also fumbled. And another miscue as Brady's pass is dropped by Sammy Morris, who would have had a first down.
It's just a matter of time before Carolina makes a play to kind of reestablish field position. And the New England Patriots have wasted a lot of opportunities right around the midfield point. And Sammy Morris has got to make the catch. Does it need to be in a better position by Tom Brady? Yes, it should be. But it's not. It's still a catchable ball. Make the plays that are going to give you another set of downs.
The 5th drop pass for New England today. Hanson punting to Munderwin. Out of bounds. So Carolina with a 7-0 lead will start from their own 20-yard line. Twenty-one consecutive home regular season wins for Tom Brady. Patriots trail Carolina today 7-0. Matt Moore, 2nd consecutive start for the injured Jake Delhomme. D'Angelo Williams. Williams picks up a first down out across the 30-yard line, gain of 11.
Well, we've been talking about this emotional lull right now for the New England Patriots, and normally during this time, one of these guys would have stepped up. Now, these guys are all from the defensive side of the ball, but somebody would have stepped up and challenged this team. It's the offensive guys that make the big plays, and you see what they're missing right there. 16 Super Bowl rings, 8 Pro Bowls with that group. The leadership has kind of been lost on the defensive side of the ball. Nobody's really stepped up to assert themselves to take that over.
On the end around, this is Smith. And Smith hurdles out to the 36, gain of 5, and all 8 of those faces were with the Patriots when they played in their last Super Bowl, Super Bowl 42, the 3-point loss to the Giants.
That's a nice move by Steve Smith. Just hurdle right up. You could do that, Darryl. I saw you jump.
Not that high. Well, be able to jump over a guy who was laying on the ground.
You know, one of the interactive exhibits over at the hall at Patriot Place involved vertical leap.
I was very disappointed to see how far my vertical leap has diminished since my playing days.
Pass is caught by the tight end, Jeff King.
Is it bad when you do it and the thing just starts laughing at you? It doesn't even give you a number? I mean, that's what it did to me. I was a little embarrassed. I walked away real quick.
Well, here it is. I mean, we've talked about New England missing out on some opportunities. Carolina's got a drive right now. We're going to change field position. You know, the New England Patriots are not going to start getting this ball out at midfield unless Tony shakes the ground and causes a fumble.
I'm trying.
Third down and one. It looks like Panthers did get enough. With the fullback, Brad Hoover. Under 6 minutes to play, second quarter. John Fox's Panthers started the season 0-3. They've won 5 of their last 9 games. First ever trip to Gillette Stadium during the regular season for the Carolina Panthers. They have played here in the preseason, but they also played across the street in the old stadium. Here's Stewart. Jonathan Stewart. Out to the 43-yard line. Gain of just 1.
Well, that was a good job by the New England Patriot defense keeping Jonathan Stewart moving laterally. And then the one thing you don't want to let Jonathan Stewart do is get his body turned north and south coming downhill. They did a nice job of forcing him to the sideline. And that's usually what you've gotten from Carolina during this transition of trying to minimize those turnovers that were happening during the course of the passing game.
Second down and 9 off the fake to Stewart. The pass is caught for a first down. There is a flag. Steve Smith gains 14 down to the 42-yard line.
Good job by Steve
Prior
Smith.
To the pass, holding. Defense number 28, penalties declined, first down.
Darius Butler, the rookie out of UConn.
A lot of people talk about breakaway speed as a way to create separation, but it's also how quickly you can stop. And watch Steve Smith right there. Watch how quick he stops. Darius Butler isn't ready for that. He's got to reach back and get a piece of jersey from Steve Smith, but a great job of being able to get in and out of that break to create his separation.
You know, watching Matt Moore from down here on the field, he's really settling down, Darrell. He's taking his time. That play action gave him a little bit more time to find his receivers, but he's getting better as the game goes along.
First
Panthers call timeout.
Carolina.
With 4.5 remaining. Second quarter, Panthers 7. Patriots nothing. Well, next week, week 15 of the National Football League, a doubleheader weekend here on Fox. We'll look at the early games, and then the Green Bay Packers travel to Pittsburgh. It all begins with the Built for Tough Fox NFL Sunday pregame show at 12 Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. How about the Packers in Chicago today? They have won their last 4 games.
Well, I think maybe the biggest question is, what about those Steelers? My goodness, we had them against Minnesota earlier this year. Now, Minnesota really kind of lost that game in the fourth quarter, but what has happened to the Pittsburgh Steelers over the last 5 or 6 weeks? Just absolutely unbelievable.
Hey, I'll tell you what, that's a completely different team without Troy Polamalu back there in that secondary.
I agree.
You don't know how much that guy covers, how much of the field and just shuts things down. I'll tell you, completely different team without that guy.
2-6 without Polamalu this season. 1st and 10 from the 42. Play action. Moore with time dumps it off, but Stewart lost his footing.
Let's see what happens to Jonathan Stewart as he releases here. See if he gets tripped up.
Now 2nd and 10 from the New England 42. Stewart down to the 35-yard line, a gain of 7.
And there you saw the end of that run. And instead of Jonathan Stewart having to force it out to the sideline and stay lateral to the line of scrimmage, he's able to square his shoulders. And he is very physical at the end of the run. Watch, he gets him square right there. Takes on Brandon Merriweather. drives him back for a couple more yards.
Keeps them legs pumping after contact. He gets, resets his hips and just keeps his legs moving.
Panthers led by Williams and Stewart. Third of the league in rushing this season. They average 152 yards on the ground. Today's leaders, third down and three. And Moore's pass is short. He was looking for the fullback, Brad Hoover.
Boy, did Tully Bantakane get a great jump on this. He was in the backfield immediately. I thought he was offsides. He got such a good jump. Watch 95, the bottom of your screen. D'Angelo Williams can't wait. He's got to keep going. And Brad Hoover, he can help him out a little bit by making Tully Bantakane just hesitate for a second. Act like you're going to cut him and get him to put his hands down. Take away that momentum so he can't get right on top of your running back in protection.
So now John Casey out to attempt a 53-yard field goal. His season-long is 50 from the right hash. The kick by Casey is short.
I don't know, Tony, on this kind of day, if John
weather.
Fox, yeah, exactly, if we're talking about field position and playing a certain style to try and keep pace with this New England team, I would have thought that they would even try to pooch kick. I was waiting for it to be snapped directly to John Casey and him pooching the ball down.
Yeah, because of that rain goes and gets on that ball and makes it heavier. So if his long was 50 and now he's going for 53, it's like almost kicking a 60-yarder because of the weight of the ball. The ball's going to drop and not have that velocity to get through that upright.
They did such a good job on that drive of changing field position with the punt. You really could have affected it, but now New England's got the ball outside their 40 again.
From the spot of the kick, Maroney. Maroney out to the 49-yard line, gain of six. Damian Lewis made the tackle.
One thing about this Carolina defense, Darrell, everybody's running to the ball. I mean, the whole team, if they get on the ground, they're up, they're running. Tell you what, they got something to prove here today in New England.
There's Casey, who missed the 53-yarder. Under 3 minutes to play, first half. Second down and four. Brady working for Ben Watson, and a penalty marker is thrown. James Anderson on the coverage.
I don't know, Darrell. It looked like pretty good coverage to me.
Pass interference, defense number 55. Automatic first down.
Ben Watson on the outside working man-to-man. Let's see if James gets his head turned around. The big thing, Tony, is he never gets his head back, you know. You see right there, there's a little bit of contact. He's got the arm up. If he gets his head turned around, I don't think they're going to be able to throw the flag.
30 yards on the penalty. That's the longest gain of the day for New England.
I'll take it any way they can get it right now.
From the Carolina 21, Maroney gets to turn the corner. And is tackled at the 18-yard line after a gain of three. Maroney was ruled down. Second and seven upcoming. Brady on second and seven. Complete to Welker for a Patriots first down. Welker's fourth reception today, his 99th of the season, and that will take us to the two-minute warning.
You look at that five-year stretch from 04 to 08, over 60% of the time in the red zone, they're scoring touchdowns. This year, they're under 50%, one of the big areas that they were focusing on this week during practice.
First and 10 from just outside the 10. This is Kevin Falk. And Falk takes it down to the 5-yard line.
Yeah.
Last time the Patriots were shut out in the first half, you have to go back to December of 2006 in Miami. Second down and four. Brady looking end zone, a penalty flag is thrown, and the pass intended for Randy Moss. It's against Carolina.
Holding, defense number 41. Half of this to the goal, automatic first down.
Captain Munnerlin.
New set of downs, you were going to third down.
Munnerlin and grabbed hold of Isaiah Stanback.
You know what, Tony?
They're calling a tight game, man.
They are.
Wow. That's inside 5 yards.
Inside five yards. He didn't. That's a big call right there. You're talking about third down from the five right now for the Patriots if you don't make that call.
First and goal from the two. Falk in the backfield. Walker in the slot. Kevin Falk.
They have 11 guys on the field on that one down. She just walked on it. Look right like in the end zone on that one. Wow.
Looked like they had 7 or 8.
Wow.
That was way too easy.
The senior member of the Patriots in his 11th season, Kevin Falk, scores his second touchdown this year. Mostowski, the extra point. I think John Fox is thinking about his decision to attempt that 53-yard field goal instead of punting it.
Yeah, I don't think he really wanted to give New England that type of field position late in the half, but here he comes, Kevin Falk coming right at you. John Beeson tries to undercut it. Dan Coppin had put himself in a position to get him, but when John Beeson, 52, tries to undercut that and run around the center, that's what happens. You vacate a huge
spot. The 30 yards Patriots gain on the pass interference call as well.
It's tough, Tony. You come out, you're inside the 5 yard line. You got Randy Moss split out wide to the right. You got Wes Welker working the slot to your left. You got Kevin Falk in the backfield, who's a great receiver out of the backfield.
Yep.
There's a lot of things for that defense to think about.
Yeah, but Carolina, we talked about it, how flat, this New England team was, and they just gave them life with a penalty. And, now all of a sudden they go in at half, and they're like, we're in this thing. Let's go. Let's go. That's something you don't want to do, is give a team like New England any kind of confidence coming out of the second half.
And remember, Goose, the Patriots deferred after they won the toss, so they will get the ball first in the second half. Mostowski's kickoff taken at the 9 by Sutton. Tyrell Sutton still on his feet across the 30. 23-yard return. Coming up, the Visa Halftime Report with Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Jimmy. They'll have scores and highlights, and the Fox Sports ticker will have all the latest stats. That's coming up on the Visa Halftime Report. Matt Moore with 1:02 remaining. And 2 timeouts. As the rain continues to fall here in Foxborough. Panthers start from their own 31-yard line. Moore spins away, gets rid of it to Rosario. And Rosario picks up 3 out to the 34-yard line.
That's a good job, though, by Matt Moore getting that ball delivered. Otherwise, you got sack negative yardage with the clock running. So,
he's hit a couple of unorthodox throws for Moore. Second down and 7. Moore to the outside to Muhammad. for a Panthers first down out to the 42.
You wonder if this possession is just as much about not being able to give the ball back to New England that had all three timeouts left.
Moore fires, and it is picked off by Lee Bodden. What'd you say about not getting the ball back to New England?
Yeah. Seven seconds left.
Lee Bodden comes up with his team-leading sixth interception of the season.
Down at the bottom.
Pass was intended for Dwayne Jarrett. First Carolina turnover today.
Matt Moore got roughed up. Derek Burgess getting him as he's getting driven back. Dwayne Jarrett has got to work his due to make sure that that was a clean interception.
No challenges, of course, in the final 2 minutes of either half from the coaches. What do you think?
Carolina might be able to get this one back. The question is, did he have complete possession when that ball did hit the ground? And the ground did not help him establish possession. And then the other question is there enough evidence to overturn it? There's our best shot right here. Lee Bodd continues to move forward. You can see the ball hit the ground right there, but that doesn't negate the interception if he had complete control of the ball. If he'd established possession at that point, as long as the ground did not aid him in establishing possession.
It was ruled an interception on the field, so there must be indisputable visual evidence in order to give the ball back to Carolina. It will either be Patriots football or second down and 10 for the Panthers.
If the New England does get the ball, I'm interested to see what they're going to do. Are you going to try and do something quick with the 7 seconds and the timeouts left and then maybe take a long field goal? Or with a guy like Randy Moss, do you just take a shot into the end zone?
May as well. Here comes Terry McCauley.
After you, the defender did not control the ball while the ball hit the ground. The pass is incomplete. Second and 10 on the 42-yard line. Please set the game clock to 10 seconds.
So it is ruled that Lee Bodden did not have control.
And you see right there, he doesn't have control before that ball hits the ground, so in that situation the ground does aid in establishing possession.
And they have added 3 seconds to the game clock, so 10 seconds remaining. Second and 10 for the Panthers from their own 42. And now a timeout is taken by New England. A look at Moore's numbers today. Matt Moore originally signed with the Dallas Cowboys, was in camp in 2007. They wanted to keep him around in their practice squad, but he was claimed on waivers by Carolina.
Yeah, they knew if they put him on the practice squad, he wasn't going to be there.
He's a halftime report coming up with Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Jimmy. Scores and highlights on the Fox Sports ticker. That's coming up on the Visa halftime report. Moore, as a rookie, made 3 starts for DeLome, went 2-1. He was named NFC Offensive Rookie of the Month in December of 2007, missed all of last season after suffering a broken fibula in the final preseason game.
It's one of those situations where your coaching staff is trying to figure out the roster at the end of preseason, and unfortunately for the Cowboys and fortunately for Carolina, he became a casualty trying to get stuck through the practice squad.
Here's Moore on second down. Rosario out of bounds with 4 seconds on the clock. Gain of just 2 for Dante Rosario. Panthers line up three receivers to the right.
Second.
And another timeout is taken by New England.
Go back and take a look at this first half. Some turnovers early on for the Carolina Panthers. And then Matt Moore finally got on track, hit Steve Smith on the deep post pattern for a touchdown. But this long field goal attempt by the Carolina Panthers, 53 yards, gave New England great field position again. They used that great field position, finally used that great field position to get down the field and get 7 points on the touchdown run by Kevin Falk.
You know, in a game against Denver earlier this season, end of the half Hail Mary situation, Bill Belichick put Randy Moss out on defense and he came away with an interception.
He's not out there right now.
Nope. Third down and 8. As Moore fires, Muhammad with the lateral. Here's Steve Smith. And he's knocked out of bounds by Brandon Merriweather. And the first half comes to an end.
I like that play.
Panthers picked up some yardage.
Yeah.
But the half comes to an end. Tied at 7. We'll return to Foxborough. Back in Foxborough. Panthers and Patriots tied at 7. Our Avatar game summary.
Well, I think the big thing right now, we've got two things going on. Look at the penalties for the Carolina Panthers. As you pointed out, Kenny, the end of that first half, a big 30-yard pass interference. And then the turnovers for the Patriots. So kind of balanced each other out during the course of that game. Opportunities given to Carolina through turnovers. The big opportunity given to New England with some penalties on that last drive.
Avatar in theaters everywhere on Friday. Patriots deferred at the start of the game, so they get the ball first here in the second half. A penalty flag as Maroney takes it out to the 22-yard line.
Holding receiving team number 34. Half the distance to go. Correction, 10-yard penalty. First down.
So Terry McCauley explaining the holding call on the kickoff as we start the second half. Darrell, Patriots only 7 points, fewest they've scored in a first half this season.
Very surprised to see the lack of offensive production from the New England Patriots. I really felt that that they were going to be able to take advantage of what Carolina was doing defensively with some of the weapons that they have. Jimmy Johnson talked about maybe taking the ball out of Tom Brady's hands in the first half, and Tony's talked about the weather here that's moving this way. We'll have to wait and see if that has any impact on this. I still feel, you know, New England is built around throwing the football, and I know that Tom Brady is really beat up right now with the rib, the shoulder, the finger on the throwing hand. But that is what this offense is about. And, you know, whether it's conditions or the injuries that he's got right now, you know, you need to stay true to who you are. It'll be interesting to see how that works itself out during the second half.
Falk gained 4 on first down, and mentioned the injuries. 3 separate injuries listed on the injury report this week with regard to Brady. Did throw the ball 15 times in the first half, 8 of 15. Now second down and 6. Lawrence Maroney. Maroney picks up a first down. Knocked out of bounds by Munnerlin at the 26-yard line after a gain of 12.
Lawrence Maroney able to get out on that edge. Julius Peppers inside working against Matt Light. Here comes the convoy. Dan Coppin out there as the center. And that's what you do. You pull around that edge and then you just look for color. If there's a different color jersey out there, put a helmet on.
You mentioned Matt Light. Patriots have been rotating their tackles today. Light, Nick Kazier, and Sebastian Vollmer. Off the play fake. Brady steps up and then took a hit from Charles Johnson.
Charles Johnson getting the start for Tyler Brayton, who didn't make the trip. 95, working the outside, gets that corner, nice dip right there. And again, that was a long developing play. Now Tom extended that play by the movement in the pocket. Charles Johnson never gave up on that one, kept working to get that pressure.
Second and 10. Brady rolls to his right, then throws to his left to Maroney. And And Maroney has another first down, chased out by Beeson at the 38-yard line after gaining 12 more yards.
I like the little element of moving the pocket, too, with this screen. Watch Tom Brady. He's going to kind of move to his right a little bit, slide that protection, and you slip the running back out the backside, understanding that that was Julius Peppers there, who's ridiculously athletic as a defensive end. Got it over top of him.
On the 38-yard line, a big hole for Kevin Faulk. Faulk takes it into Carolina territory. Finally tackled by Charles Godfrey after a gain of 19.
Well, they have found something soft in the middle. Kevin Falk's touchdown run was straight up the gut. This one, a big gainer coming right up the middle. Sammy Morris gets up, gets the block on John Beeson. Nothing fancy there.
The longest play for the Patriots today on offense, not including the 30-yard pass interference call. From the 43, off the play fake to Morris. Brady with loads of time. He throws, and it's complete for the tight end, Benjamin Watson, for another Patriots first down at the Panthers 25, 18-yard pass play.
Now here's what Randy Moss does for this offense. On play action pass, he's your deep threat. Watch how well Carolina has this covered. They got a couple safeties back there. Now what happens next is you've got to have the other option. Ben Watson does a good job of getting into a good spot for Tom Brady to throw the ball, and then works the sideline real well for the big tight end.
Fourth first down of this drive, and the first catch for Watson today. From the 25, it's Sammy Morris. And Morris lost the football. Wow. The third Patriots turnover today.
What an impressive drive to start this second half. It looked like New England had everything kind of corrected from halftime, but Charles Godfrey knocks it loose from Sammy Morris.
Back in Foxborough, the New England Patriots, Darrell, over their first 12 games, committed only 15 turnovers, fourth fewest in the league. They matched their season high with three today.
Very uncharacteristic.
Panthers start from their own 14-yard line as Moore hands it off to D'Angelo Williams, and Williams is all the way out to the 40-yard line. He gains 26 on first down.
Well, he is very, very elusive. D'Angelo Williams, 34. Brad Hoover out front gets the block at the point of attack. Now he's loose into the secondary. Great vision down the field to get some extra yards.
It's Wolfork, a little late getting up. Looks like he did a little something.
Yeah, he had he was carrying something from the first half, Tony. He was questionable coming in.
Yeah,
with
I think it was a
with
foot.
A foot.
Yeah. Well, he's not too happy right now. He's limping over. That's a big loss for that New England defense.
Well, that's a huge loss. And with the game being the way it is, because it's a tight game, now Carolina can come back and lean on the running game, which they're very, very good at. And now, if Vince Wilfork can't come back into the game, I mean, that even plays into a bigger advantage for the Carolina Panthers.
Yep. John Fox is one of those guys, if he sees an injury or a new guy coming in, that's where he's going to attack and see if he does it.
Replaced by Titus Adams, number 62, signed off the practice squad this week. Moore on first down, complete to the tight end, King. In Patriots territory, Lee Bott in the tackle. Jeff King gains 13 yards. There's Adams, drafted by the Jets back in 2006. Activated just this week from the practice squad by New England. And he's in for Vince Wilfork here in the third quarter of a 7-7 game. On the Patriots, 48. Williams up the middle. Gain of three down to the 45. Ty Warren made the tackle.
Tony, we talked during the course of the weekend, and I really felt that you know, Matt Moore was going to have to put some points up, that this game would not have the complexion that it has right now. I never thought we'd be 7-7 in the third quarter. I thought that they were going to have to loosen the reins on Matt Moore, have the confidence and the trust in him to be able to throw the football, because New England was going to put points on the board. The longer this game stays like this, the more dangerous this Panther offense is going to become.
Absolutely. We thought that it was going to be, you know, a catch-up game for Carolina, but they're doing a great job of executing their game plan and just chipping away.
Moore on second and seven, looking for Smith downfield, and it's broken up by Brandon Merriweather.
One thing Matt Moore's got to be careful of is just lobbing that ball up and letting it float back there, because those defensive backs will go up and get it for the New England Patriots.
Yeah, on the touchdown, it was a one-on-one situation. There was no safety help, and he was able to float that one. But on that one, Brandon Merriweather was playing center field, comes over to make a play on the ball. Actually, you got him in a game like this, and the handful of plays, I mean, we come back to it. The Patriots were so used to seeing them make those types of plays. We're used to seeing Brandon Merriweather come down with an interception in that situation in the past by other guys.
They're down at seven. Panthers must get to the 38, and they do. There is a flag. Smith takes it down to the 30 for a Panthers first down.
Illegal shift, offense. Two-man moving, did not reset for a second. Five-yard penalty. Third down.
That's unacceptable right there. Big third down conversion, and you've got something fundamental. It shouldn't happen, and it's happened twice to Carolina today. Now, I don't know if it's a cadence situation with Matt Moore being in there instead of Jake DeLone, but you cannot have two guys moving prior to the snap.
Another element that everybody has to adjust to when you have a new quarterback going in is the cadence and getting set. We've seen it twice so far in this game.
The sixth Carolina penalty, New England has committed just one. Third down and 12 from midfield. Sutton in the backfield. Another flag. As Moore moves to his right, dumps it off to the tight end Rosario. Gary Guyton makes the tackle at the 41-yard line after a gain of 9.
I don't know if it was illegal shift or illegal man in motion. Yeah, again. I mean, Musa Muhammad was having a very, very difficult time getting lined up.
There are two fouls, illegal shift, offense, two and moving. That penalty's declined. Illegal formation, offense, five-yard penalty, third down.
Well, see, what happened right there is Musa Muhammad was going to talk to Wayne Jarrett, and they were both moving at the same time. And now Musa's got to come to a complete stop at some point, because they were both moving as he was trying to get the information relayed to him. And because he stayed in continuous motion and never came completely set for 1 second, you're going to have the illegal shift. It goes against Moosen, but Moosen's got to help Dwayne get lined up.
So third down and 17 following the second consecutive penalty. Moore to Sutton. And Sutton tackled at the 42-yard line. So the Panthers will send out the punting unit.
Boy, that was a big pre-snap penalty. The first illegal shift that wrecked that drive.
Jason Baker. Fair catch called for him. And then Welker lets it go. And the question is, was Dante Wesley able to keep it out of the end zone? Stepped on the line. It's a touchback. Well, I thought Dante Wesley stepped on the goal line. The ball spotted on the 4, and it looks like Bill Belichick has the challenge flag in his hand.
I think he agrees with your assessment of it early on too, Kenny. He's going to throw that flag and have the have a review of this. The big question is there an angle that definitively shows that he was not on the line? We haven't really seen one as of yet, but that is definitely worth the challenge. First and 10 at the 4,
New England,
or first and 10 at the 20?
That it was a touchback on the preceding play. Timeout.
Terry McCauley will take a look at it. As Darryl mentioned prior to the break,
the ruling on the field stands. New England charged with their first team timeout.
I was going to say it will either be first and 10 from the 4 or the 20, and it turns out it will be from the 4.
Well, you know, Coach Belichick figured it was worth the risk to take the challenge, but it was going to be hard from, you know, from camera angle. Sometimes that point of view gets distorted a little bit, and I just don't think we were ever going to get that clear shot. Dante,
well, later in the game, I don't think there was a, you know, what we saw. Obviously, it's easier for us, but I don't think it was close enough to try and
down. So here's Maroney on first down. Takes it out to the 6-yard line. Dan Connor, the tackle. Patriots in the first half this season have outscored their opponents by 107 points. They are minus 3 in the second half and overtime. Season low, 7 first half points today.
Got a good matchup down here at the bottom of the screen.
Second down. Oh, what a hit by Godfrey on Welker, and that is catch number 100 of the season for Welker.
I tell you, he is the epitome of a football player. Undersized guy.
See how he hold on to that ball there, even when he got hit. Well, he wraps it up.
Guys, Welker joins Marvin Harrison, Jerry Rice, and Herman Moore, fourth player in history with 3 consecutive seasons with at least 100 receptions. And he's also done it in 11 games. And that ties Marvin Harrison's record as well. He missed 2 games earlier this season. And there's number 101. A Patriots first down.
And again, that's Wes Welker at his best. It's a crossing route coming into the middle of the field through a whole bunch of traffic. You've got another player from the Patriots coming across. You're going against the linebackers. You got an umpire in the middle. Watch how he works the field. He's able to do this without ever really breaking stride. That's such a tough chore for Chris Harris.
From the 30 on first down, Maroney. Michael Jenkins did not play last week, and the Falcons lost to Philadelphia. Second down and 6. Kevin Falk, stutter step. And now takes it out to the 35-yard line. Falk has the Patriots touchdown today, late in the second quarter.
Good patience again by Kevin Falk. He's moving to his right, trying to get outside. Logan Mankins gets everything kicked out. He gets back inside Charles Johnson.
On the 35-yard line on first down, Brady to Welker. His 7th catch today, another New England first down out to the 49, a gain of 13.
Yeah, that's just not fair for Dan Connor to get stuck in a one-on-one situation with Wes Welker. He's going to come in motion and come across. Tom Brady knows exactly where he wants to go with the football. He saw by the motion across formation from Wes Welker that he was going to get matched up with a linebacker one-on-one. He locked onto him for the whole play.
13 completions for Brady. 7 have gone to Welker as Falk gains 5 down to the Carolina 47.
I mean, picking up right where they left off on their opening drive of this half, going right down the field before they had another turnover and fumbled the ball. They've got to learn to finish. And it was something that Tom Brady, Wes Welker, Brandon Merriweather, everybody challenged this Patriot team. We've got to become mentally tough. We've got to finish off games. Right now, they've got to finish off this drive and get some points.
It's a one-man show right now with Wes Welker.
There's Falk on 2nd and 5, and Kevin Falk has another Patriots first down. This drive started at their own 4-yard line. So they've already marched 56 yards.
really keeping them off balance with the play calling.
And with just two guys, Kevin Faulk, run the ball. Okay, next play, Wes Welker, catch the ball. It's going back and forth. The other two guys you got a key on if you're this defense.
Now Maroney in the backfield. First and 10 from the Panthers 40. Goose again, it's Welker. His fourth reception of this drive. He gains 9.
The one thing that they're doing that I see is wrong is Wes Welker. You can't go and play him off the line of scrimmage. Look how much area he has right there. Moss does a good job of blocking on the outside, but you can't let them go and get the ball into Wes Welker's hands because he's the most dangerous when he has the ball and he's running downfield. He has the speed and the quickness to make a little play turn into a giant play, and that's what we're seeing right here.
10th play of the drive for New England. Second down and 1. Off the play fake. Brady to Welker. And Welker is inside the 10. His fifth reception of this drive. First and goal for the Patriots following the 23-yard pass play.
Coming out of the slot at the top of the screen. Again, he's just so good at finding his way through all the traffic. Gets into that soft spot in the zone right in the middle. I mean, his ability, his quickness, his toughness, but again, Tony, how about his endurance? I mean, the guy's a punt returner, the kick returner. He's been featured on this long drive.
And Tom Brady's just looking where Wes is. He's not even looking to see where Randy Moss is or anybody else in the passing game.
Here's Maroney with Welker and Moss on the sidelines. And Maroney gains 3 down to the Carolina 6. Moss now back onto the field.
He's not even breathing heavy, Darrell. Look, I'm breathing heavier down here in the end zone walking around. I mean, that guy, there's no smoke coming out of his mouth at all.
He's a machine.
Unbelievable.
9 catches today, 5 on this drive, 104 on the season. Second and goal, Maroney. Down just inside the 5 as Welker returns.
Just a lot of weapons to cover in this package. It's in there right now, Tony. And you switch personnel. Now here comes Moss, Welker, and Faulk on the field again. And they're all to one side at this point. There goes Wes in motion.
Keep your eye on that guy right there.
Third and goal from the 5. Brady looking end zone. He throws. Touchdown. Ben Watson.
Was one of the points you made at the top, Tony. You know, you try to take away Wes Welker, you try to take away Randy Moss, you're worried about Kevin Faulk. There's got to be opportunities for other people on this offense. And Tom Brady able to find Ben Watson for the touchdown catch. Working against John Beeson, just gets that step pretty quick.
Tom Brady did a nice job of fitting that ball right between two defenders, too. That ball was right on the target.
Patriots drive 96 yards, their longest drive of the season. And they have their first lead of the afternoon. 5th trip to the end zone this season for Watson. Patriots have given their fans something to cheer about.
A lot different than the first half, guys, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. Went from complete dead silence in the stadium to electricity like you can't believe.
13 plays, 96 yards. 5 catches for Welker on the drive. And a touchdown pass from Brady to Watson. Patriots a perfect 6-0 at home this season with a 14-7 lead. Sutton on the return. Rob Ninkovich the tackle. 1 minute remaining, 3rd quarter. Panthers offense back out trailing by a touchdown. Look at Jake DeLome, starting quarterback in Super Bowl 38 for the Carolina Panthers against the New England Patriots back in February of 2004. Game won by the Patriots, 42-29. Seven players remaining on each side from that Super Bowl. As D'Angelo Williams picks up a first down out across the 45-yard line to the 47. Williams gains 22.
Well, for the second time in a row to start the drive, D'Angelo Williams is breaking off a huge run. And he doesn't slow down when he changes direction. It's so fun to watch him run. As he changes direction, it's like his pace never stops.
Averaging 8 yards per carry today. Patriots still without Vince Wilfork. Left the game earlier this half. Williams into New England territory. And that should bring us to the end of the third quarter. The go-ahead touchdown scored by Benjamin Watson as Pierre Woods is slow to get up. Clock stops with 7 seconds remaining.
And that'll get them kind of thin at the outside linebacker spot. Adalis Thomas inactive today. Pierre Woods getting the start for Adalis. So Rob Ninkovich is going to have to come in and play the outside linebacker spot.
Woods also the top tackler on special teams for the Patriots.
Looks like he's going to be all right. He'll be back in.
So that will do it for the third quarter here at Foxborough with the Patriots leading the Panthers 14-7. Fox NFL Sunday will return after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. They begin the fourth quarter, 14-7 New England. Darrell, everybody we spoke with on the Patriots side talked about finishing games. They've blown 3 fourth quarter leads this season, all on the road. They are perfect here at home, but finishing teams out of the fourth quarter was a phrase that we heard on numerous occasions. Here's Moore on second down. Complete to Williams. He's tackled by Mayo after a gain of 6 as we check in once again with Kurt Menefee.
It's good to see them bounce back.
Here's Stewart.
That may be the ugliest 3-yard gain I've ever seen.
He kept going, though. He was facing the wrong way. He spun. He looks like he crawled for a couple. Any way you can get him, Darryl.
Second down and 8 from the Patriots 41. Play action. Moore looking for Rosario. And Dr. Wow. Rosario made the catch, a spectacular catch by the Panthers tight end as he picks up a first down, a gain of 21.
Carolina hurrying up to try and prevent a challenge.
No challenge flag is thrown. Hand off to Stewart on first down. And Stewart fights forward for a yard.
We'll go back and see if that approach by Carolina was warranted. Dante Rosario, a great job and good coverage again. You got two Patriots right there. He just goes up over the top and takes it away. Yeah, both feet get down. He's got control as he goes out of bounds.
That's a catch.
That's fantastic. Sees he gets it secure. Gets both feet in.
Matt Moore's doing a great job of putting that ball up and letting his receivers go up and get it. That's a perfect example right there.
Second down and 9. Williams back in. And Williams runs into the arms of Ty Warren after gaining just 1.
Kenny, you mentioned the trouble that New England's been having in the fourth quarter. There's a lot of things that you can go back and draw parallels to back during that period of success. 2001 to 2008 only happened one time. It's happened 3 times this season. And there's a number of categories that kind of fit into that same type of profile.
Ty Warren shaking up. The blown fourth quarter leads this year at Denver, at Indianapolis, at Miami. Back at Foxborough on a rainy Sunday afternoon in December. Patriots lead the Panthers 14-7. Third down and 8 for Carolina. From the New England 18. Pass intended for Steve Smith. Merriweather on the coverage.
Well, they lined up Steve Smith in the backfield. You're going to get your pressure right into Matt Moore's face. Not enough time to get this play developing down the sideline. Steve Smith wanted it up in the air so he could run underneath it. Again, that's a little bit of time. Some reps together with Matt Moore and Steve Smith to get on the same page.
Well, John Casey missed from 53 yards out earlier to attempt a 36-yard field goal from the left hash. Kick by Casey is good. So the Panthers pull to within 4 early in the fourth quarter. Here's Dante Rosario, who made a tremendous catch along the sidelines during the 57-yard drive. John Casey, a 36-yard field goal, pulling Carolina to within 4. Carolina 5-7, tough schedule down the stretch. Minnesota at the Giants and then home to the Saints. They trail this game by 4. Maroney on the return. And Maroney finally brought down at the 24-yard line by Quentin Culberson.
Let's go back and take a look at that last opportunity for the Carolina Panthers. You're going to get your blitz from Jonathan Wilhite here. That means Brandon Merriweather's got a strange angle to come up and get Steve Smith, who's coming out of the backfield. Matt Moore's just got to trust this and float it up in the air and let Steve Smith kind of go down the sideline and run underneath it into that area right there. And again, that's repetitions together. Those are some of the things that you have to overcome when you've got your backup quarterback in there.
From the 24-yard line, Sammy Morris. Morris gains 1 out to the 25. James Anderson made the tackle. Patriots drove 96 yards on their last possession. Tom Brady, 16 of 24. Wes Welker, 9 receptions, including 5 on that last drive.
And the only thing that has stopped the New England Patriots in this second half is themselves. They had the fumble on their opening possession, but they were going right down the field on that one.
Empty backfield for New England, second down and 9.
West! Right! Ram it, Omaha, go!
Brady to Welker, his 10th catch today. A Patriots first down.
I mean, I don't know if Carolina is not seeing Wes Welker out there. Watch him. He's right here. There's nobody on him. He just sits down, gets the ball. Everyone's running away from him. You can't do that. Somebody needs to be on him, pressing him, challenging him at the line of scrimmage. Or do you just, Tom Brady's going to find him all day, and this is what you're going to get. They're going to go right down the field again.
Goose, it's the 6th 10 catch game this season for Welker. From the 38, Falk. Gain of 3 out to the 41.
It's one of those situations, Tony, where you make the decision, you know what, you may beat us, but you're not going to beat us with that guy right there. You know, we're going to take him away from you or make it a little bit harder. And I think on that last one, you had Dante Wesley, who kind of had him fronted up like he was going to cover him, and then all of a sudden he turns and runs with the tight end, Ben Watson. Make Ben Watson beat you down the field. Don't bracket him high-low. Stay inside out on Wes Welker.
Absolutely.
So 10 receptions for Welker. Boss only one, and he fumbled. Turned the ball over on his only reception today. Second down at 7. From the 40. Wide open is the tight end, Watson. A New England first down, 14-yard pass play.
Well, you knew they had to find that third receiver. I thought it was going to be Julian Edelman, but it looks like it's Benjamin Watson right here. Just goes right down the field, finds the hole. Tom Brady finds them. I mean, they're keeping this secondary of the Carolina Panthers totally off balance right now. It's a guessing game out there.
Well, there's such an opportunity for whoever that person is that becomes the number three for New England, because you've got so much attention with Wes Welker and Randy Moss that you're going to draw single coverage, or you're not going to be the focus of the defense the majority of the game.
On first down, Maroney. Maroney fights his way down to the 36-yard line of the Panthers. A gain of 9.
I think right now the Carolina Panthers have to go and make a decision. Are we going to go and blitz and pressure Tom Brady and try to force him into a bad throw? Or are we just going to sit back and let them go and just pick us apart? And that's exactly what's happening right now with Wes Welker. Wes Welker and Tom Brady are picking apart this secondary.
Second and one, Maroney. Penalty marker as Maroney has a first down at the Panthers 33. Nick Cowser shaking up. Right tackle.
Bill use of hands to the face. Defense, number 98. 5-yard penalty at the end of the play. First down.
That's on Nick Hayden. We mentioned earlier, we've seen Cowser rotating in and out today. As we take a look at the penalty on Hayden. We'll be back. First and 10 for the Patriots from the Panthers 29. New England leading by 4. Inside handoff to Falk. And he's tackled by Damian Lewis. No gain on the play.
Yeah, but Charles Johnson made the play, forced him to change direction very quickly. He's had a nice afternoon today filling in for Tyler Brayton.
Got some quickness right there on the big man. Does a nice job of getting penetration. That's what you got to do to slow down these running backs. Penetrate that line of scrimmage.
Prior to the commercial break, Patriots lost right tackle Nick Cowser, replaced by Sebastian Vollmer, who's played at both tackle positions today. With the play clock at 5, Patriots shuffling in personnel. New England uses a timeout.
Second charge timeout, New England.
Patriots lost their first timeout on that unsuccessful challenge earlier this half. Well, weekdays make lunchtime your new prime time as FoxSports.com brings you lunch with benefits. Log on to check out new episodes of original sports shows delivered to your desktop every Monday through Friday at 1 Eastern. They're enjoying the menu. Lunch with benefits. During the Visa halftime report, the guys in the studio referenced Tom Brady becoming a father for the second time this past Tuesday. And we are told no name has been chosen as of yet.
Yeah, but there might be Wes. You know, after Wes Welker after today's game.
Could be. Lost the intended receiver.
Wes Brady, what do you guys think?
Sounds good, Goose.
You always got to worry about Randy Moss getting down the field, so he gets a lot of good, clean releases as corners will bail and gets on that slant route. And Randy's not having the best day today. It's been a tough afternoon for him.
Third down and 11. Brady steps up. Now lobs one up. Incomplete. Patriots send out the field goal unit.
Carolina Panthers able to get a little bit of pressure to the quarterback. Again, it's Charles Johnson kind of moving to the front. Julius Peppers forces Tom Brady to step up.
That's a nice job by Charles Johnson. Tell you what, getting in his face, not letting him be able to see downfield, hand up.
48-yard attempt for Gostowski. Hanson places it down. And Gostowski's kick is good. From 48. The Well, the Patriots extend their lead. It is now 17-10, New England. Patriots drive 10 plays, 46 yards. Now lead the Panthers by 7.
Loyal fans here in New England, Darryl.
Yeah, it's
not a lot leaving. They're up on their feet. It's raining, it's cold, but they're here.
Sutton from the 2. Diving at the 21 by Kyle Arrington. Carolina Panthers with Matt Moore making his second consecutive start. Led 7-0 until the latter stages of the second quarter. Patriots tied the score. Went ahead late in the third. It's now 17-10 New England. First and 10 from the 22-yard line. And Moore's pass is nearly picked off by Gary Guyton.
Matt Moore needs to put a little bit more juice on this ball, Darryl.
Yeah, Gary Guyton was not fooled by the play action. Good drop to the spot, just out on his fingertips. Yeah, I don't know. That's going to be a heck of a catch by Steve Smith out there if Gary Guyton doesn't make a deflection on that.
Second and 10. The pitch to Williams. He's tackled for a loss. Shy of the 20-yard line by Lee Bonnet. Loss of 2 on the play.
We touched on that last drive, Kenny. New England has really, really struggled to finish games this year for the first time in quite some time. So their offense comes off a drive where they get 3 points, and their defense is coming out trying to get a 3-and-out, get them back out right away, because they have been very, very efficient here in the second half offensively.
Play clock's down to 3 seconds.
Panthers with a penalty marker on 3rd and 12. Down goes Moore back at the 11-yard line.
He should have called a timeout on that play, Darryl.
You got another illegal shift, Tony.
Illegal shift, offense, penalties decline, 4th down.
Sack for Jarvis Green. Carolina will punt.
Kenny?
Wow. Russ Welker with 10 catches here, 20 receptions for Brandon Marshall of the Broncos. And here's Welker. Welker tackled at the Carolina 42 by Dan Connor. Well, this January, Fox once again brings you the greatest week in college football, beginning on New Year's Day with the All-State Sugar Bowl, the AT&T Cotton Bowl, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, and finally the FedEx Orange Bowl. The Bowl Bash begins New Year's Day on Fox in high definition. And Darryl, you will be on hand along with Pat Summerall at the Cotton Bowl.
Yeah, looking forward to that. Oklahoma State and Ole Miss. Well, I was hoping that TCU and Boise State would get a shot at one of the big boys. Disappointed to see those two matched up against each other.
Two undefeated. Brady off the hands of Morris. Now, Kurt mentioned Brandon Marshall with the 20 receptions, tying the NFL record. It was Terrell Owens with 20 catches for the 49ers against the Bears back in December of 2000. He set the record, and Marshall actually is tied for 2nd all-time, now 3rd. He caught 18 against the Chargers in one game last September. Maroney. Maroney to the 40, a gain of 2.
All right, that Goose, we've been complaining about the Carolina Panthers doing something different to Wes Welker because he's got 10 catches. You imagine watching a 20-catch performance?
Wow. You drop every defensive lineman to wherever that guy's lined up. That's what you do. Man.
Yet the Broncos still trail the Colts by 5. Indianapolis looking to break the Patriots record with a 22nd consecutive regular season win. Remember, Tom Brady has won 21 in a row here at home. Third down and 8. We approach 5 minutes remaining, fourth quarter. And the play is blown dead.
False start, offense, number 81. 5-yard penalty, third down.
He's just not here today, man. His mind is somewhere else. Randy Moss, just tough day. Tough day catching the ball, tough day trying to stay focused. I just don't understand it.
Only one reception, and he turned it over. The pass, which was picked off by Gamble in the first quarter, was headed Moss's way. And now a penalty under the second flag thrown on the Patriots today. Third down and 13. Brady with time, can't find anyone. Moves to his left, in trouble, then throws it away. He had the presence of mind. He heard Julius Peppers coming from his right side and just was able to get rid of the football.
Got rid of it and got down. Yeah, when you play against Carolina, you have to understand how athletic Julius Peppers is.
You see that white jersey as a corner of your eyes. Get rid of the ball. Watch how he takes a little shot. Here comes Julius Peppers.
Well, he can close.
So 4.5 minutes to play in the fourth. Hansen punting from his own 45. And a flag as Hansen was run into.
Should be running into.
Personal foul.
They gave him the big one.
The kicker. Defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Wow.
I don't know. I wouldn't have gone after this.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Yeah, that's legit.
It's roughing. Yep, absolutely.
That's legit.
Everett Brown, the rookie out of Florida State, second-round draft pick, commits a huge penalty. So the Patriots' offense will come back out onto the field.
There's a block point on a kicker, and when you're coming up the middle, you have to leave early, so your momentum doesn't carry you to the kicker. Preferably, you'd like to be coming in from an angle to a block point. So if you miss it and you go by, you're not going to go into the kicker. Everett Brown's got to understand that as he breaks clean up into the middle, that he's got to leave a little bit sooner to prevent that momentum from carrying him into the punter.
First and 10 from the 30-yard line, and Maroney is hit in the backfield for a loss by Chris Harris, along with Dan Connor. And Carolina calls timeout. Tremendous job, Goose.
Thank you.
Second down and 11. Penalty flag. Maroney.
Well, here's another opportunity, Kenny. You mentioned about finishing in the fourth quarter for this Patriot team.
Illegal formation. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Well, we're a one-possession game right now, and New England's fiddling away their chances to make it a two-possession game.
All right, here we go. Last month down in Charlotte.
We only did 8 laps. And, I mean, the concentration. There he goes right there. Every law of physics was just broken right there.
That slid right in, baby. 145 miles an hour.
I thought you were up over 150.
I was, but I didn't want to. 175.
Second down and 16. And that pass intended for Julian Edelman. You talked about him in the open, Tony, the rookie out of Kent State, who is returning today after missing the last 2 games.
You're going to get your opportunities, and this is an opportunity for Edelman right here. He's got to go and make this catch. That's a big play. The guy's out there. He's a tough kid. He's playing with a broken arm. See the cast on his right arm. He's been in and out of the lineup, but this is a play that he's got to go and make right here.
Quarterback in college at Kent State. Threw for nearly 5,000 yards and rushed for 2,600. Third down at 16. Brady to Falk. Shoved out of bounds by Munderland at the 29-yard line, and here comes the Patriots field goal unit once again. Stowski hit from 48 earlier. He will look to extend the New England lead to 10 points. And make this a two-possession game. 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And for Gostkowski, his 100th successful field goal, the fourth Patriot in franchise history to kick 100 field goals. And he extends the New England lead to 10.
That penalty on the punter might have put this game out of reach for the Carolina Panthers.
You're absolutely right, Goose. Everett Brown, flag for roughing the kicker. And the Patriots add three more points.
And a lot of that has been because of Wes Welker today. Just continues to do everything you ask for the New England Patriots, returning the punts, getting some great field position throughout the game. And just, you talk to Tom Brady and he's, you know, I really think the guy's uncoverable. And then you watch him out here and you talk to Chris Harris and the guys from Carolina and, you know, you really start to believe that. I mean, I don't know how you play him because he's obviously your focus and he continues to put up performances like that. You mentioned, Kenny, it's his sixth game with 10 plus catches. And he's the focus as you come into the game. So that's just,
I'll tell you what, Carolina wasn't too focused on him today. They gave him opportunities to go make plays. That's exactly what he did.
He had five receptions during that 96-yard drive in the third quarter as Sutton regains control and spins out to the 15-yard line.
That was a double spin.
So a 3:50 on the clock, and the Panthers trailing by 10. And we mentioned in our open, the Patriots with only a one-game lead in the division on the Jets and the Dolphins. Miami beat Jacksonville 14-10. Dolphins' seventh win, and the Jets are going to win. They lead Tampa Bay 26-3 with 2.5 minutes remaining. So this game huge for New England, with Miami picking up win number 7, and the Jets about to win their 7th.
Neutral zone infraction, defense, number 59. Entered the neutral zone, causing a reaction by the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Gary Guyton. Remember, the Patriots have lost their last two. They have not lost three consecutive games since the 2002 season. New England with a 10-point lead. First and 5 following the penalty. Moore's pass is caught by Muhammad. And Muhammad has a first down. We spoke earlier about that New England-Carolina Super Bowl, Super Bowl 38. Muhammad still holds the all-time Super Bowl record, 85-yard reception in that game.
Well, that was a great game, and difficult to see one team lose it. Some huge plays on both sides.
On first and 10, Moore with a low throw intended for D'Angelo Williams.
And I think that's one of the things that has drawn the confusion from Patriot fans about this team is Jeff Otaw's down. But they've been such a model of consistency. You talked about Indianapolis, you know, trying to break their consecutive regular season streak. You mentioned Tom Brady's performance here at Gillette Stadium. They won 23 out of 26 on the road prior to coming into this year. I mean, during the era of free agency, when types of things like that weren't supposed to happen, this organization has just been so consistent and played at such a high level for so long.
Ever since Robert Kraft purchased this franchise, they have the most wins in the NFL with 180, the most conference championships, and the most Super Bowl titles.
That's why when you sit at 7-5, everybody wants to know what's going on with this team.
On the 25 on second down. You know, we had a look at that 16-0 banner from 2007. And when we met with Tom Brady on Friday and we're chatting about this season, he told us, well, the ultimate goal is not to go undefeated. And, of course, we all know how that season ended for New England.
Absolutely. I see a lot of the same qualities with Tom Brady that I saw in Troy Aikman when he was the quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys when I played. The desire to win championships, it's not about individual achievements or passing yards or anything like that. It's strictly about winning championships, and I see a lot of the same personality and drive out of Tom that I saw from Troy.
They're down and 10. Moore wrapped up. Down he goes. Derek Burgess with his third sack of the season.
Derek Burgess, this is what he was brought here for. What are the things that New England has to package to the quarterback, and then the coverage on the back end, trying to figure out how to balance that. And one of the reasons Derek Burgess was brought here was to generate pressure on the quarterback. He hasn't been consistent with it during the course of the year. Maybe he can get on a little bit of a roll down the stretch here.
Burgess, one of the four who showed up late Wednesday, was sent home by Bill Belichick. Fourth down and 20. Moore dumps it off to Williams. Williams tackled. It's Burgess again who makes the tackle. And the Panthers give it up on downs.
Well, this is what Wes Welker wanted to happen today. He wanted the game to end with the offense on the field in a position to win the game, or a position to be running the clock out. It's been a while since they've had that. They had a shot last week in Miami, had the interception to end that game, but too many times Wes felt that they've put the defense back on the field to try and save the victory. And when you're an offensive player, there's not a better feeling than to be in the position the Patriot offense is in right now, and that's taking this clock down to zeros across the board.
Morris and Maroney in the backfield. First and 10 from the 24-yard line. Here's Maroney. Maroney down inside the 22 as the Panthers call timeout.
I like the 49ers-Eagles game, I'll tell you the truth. That's going to be a big one, good one. Make sure you tune into that one.
You might be there?
Yeah, we'll be doing that one, by the way.
We'll come with you, Goose. Darrell, you mentioned Dom Capers. Of course, he was the first head coach of the Carolina Panthers. Made it all the way to the NFC Championship game in there. 1996. And as the clock winds down towards the two-minute warning. So 2 minutes to play here in Foxborough. Big sack by Burgess moments ago. Patriots by 10. Bill Belichick was out for a chat with Tom Brady with the Patriots leading by 10. 2 minutes remaining.
Oh, one of the big things that they've done better this afternoon that they've struggled with over the past month is playing well in the second half. They got off to actually a slow start in the first half, which is very uncharacteristic.
On third down and one, Maroney stopped short of a first down. We welcome those of you who have just joined us. Carolina Panthers use their final timeout, trailing by 10 with 1:55 on the clock.
Well, it was a lot of Patriot mistakes that made this game close at halftime. A couple of big turnovers in the first half. Carolina able to take that interception and hit Steve Smith on the deep post pattern. Matt Moore for a 7-0 lead, but right before the end of the half, after a big pass interference penalty got him close, Kevin Falk went in. They came out, and they have been a machine offensively here in the second half. The only thing that slowed them down was a fumble on their opening drive of this second half. But other than that, they have not missed a beat.
Wes Welker for the sixth time this season, 10 receptions. You mentioned the turnovers. New England a -3 in that department.
You'd never know it by the scoreboard, -3.
It's now fourth down and one. Patriots keep their offense on the field. The handoff to Lawrence Maroney, and he picks up a first down. And now the Patriots will be able to run out the clock. Panthers are out of timeouts.
Maybe that gets him off the schneid a little bit on some of these fourth down calls over the past month, too. It's all about gaining confidence and belief in yourself. And they had another one earlier today. They went for it on fourth down, you know, around the 40-yard line of the Carolina Panthers, and Carolina stuffed that run. So Bill Belichick has gambled quite a bit with some of his play-calling decisions throughout the past month, and maybe that fourth down there gives him the confidence.
Great job by our entire crew today here in Foxborough, led by our producer Barry Landis, director Michael Frank, associate directors Jeremy Green and Darren Foster, associate producer Chirag Devaskar. Our technical producer is David M. Hill, the technical director Chris Castro, the senior producer of Fox Sports is Bill Brown, and the executive producers of Fox Sports are Ed Gorin and David Hill. Thanks to Lou Tribbiani, Dave Corris crunching the numbers, Ben Bulma, Matt Banovic, and Ricky Camps. So the Patriots are going to maintain their one-game lead in the AFC East over the Jets and Dolphins, who both won today as well. New England remains perfect at home, 7-0 for Tom Brady, his 22nd consecutive win here at Gillette Stadium. It'll be the Patriots visiting the Bills next week, while the Panthers will host the Minnesota Vikings. Carolina dropping to 5-8. So a slow start to this game for New England. They score a season low 7 first half points, but they defeat the Carolina Panthers by the score of 20-10. We'll return to Foxborough in just